worst the worst, bitch.
So the next question that we have talks about the youth and carjackings and all that's been going on with that. This person asks, what can we do to deter our youth from carjackings? Lena?
I took the mic because the first thing I want to say, and I wrote it down and heard you, Mike, when you said, presently we got 1,600 officers and 1,850 is what we need on the force. My immediate response, and you know, I posted when the Public Safety Commission said we need more police officers. I don't believe the answer is more police officers. Now, don't get me wrong, I understand that it is challenging in a community that we have to do the job if you don't have, for like I said, enough people to go around. You know, when I was a public defender, you know, your caseload got higher if you didn't have enough public defenders, enough attorneys to be able to, you know, address the issue. But, you know, call me simple-minded, right? I believe that people need a job and something to do.
That's right.
I believe that make all the difference in the world. So I'm gonna start by saying I want to see us create pathways to opportunity for people. Not just young people, but their family. Amen. And the people that are in their community also. So that's number one. Number two, if we're going to do any funding for law enforcement, I believe that we need to put some, I don't know what to call them, but I'm gonna say clauses, right? Requirements, you know, or incentives, that's a better word, incentives, that if you do cultural competency training, that maybe we create a way to say, if you do de-escalation training, cultural competency training, mental health training, you use cop houses, you use community policing, you pass out sports cards. If you do those things or some of those things and, you know, whatever, some whatever, that then maybe what we do is allow you to allow your law enforcement funding to come off of the revenue limit. I think we should do something creative to create the incentive for those things that will help us to grow our relationship that needs better communication. Because right now, the only thing we do is just fund it or don't fund it and wait on maybe a local community to make those changes, or a fire and police commission is not present to make those changes, creating an incentive that says if you do those things, we somehow or another connect that to the funding. That's what I'd like to see. So jobs and something connecting when we fund law enforcement to help us deal with what I believe is our crisis relationship that presently exists. You want me to give you the money?
Sure.
Mr. Bavillo.
Thank you. Well, the senator is absolutely right. What we do as a police force should be expectation driven by the community that we police. The community has a right to have expectations of their officers that this will take place. What is this? And what that is an absolute community-oriented style of policing, where you get out there and you get to know the individuals. But this forum here today was, I don't believe, was all directed to be, you know, what's the police department going to do to solve our problems? Just what do we all think as a panel of how we can move things forward and come together as a community? The other thing that you said that I really appreciate more and understand the need and the reasoning behind the need for more of those officers, but better yet, what do we do to affect the juvenile, the to your question.
Carjacking.
The carjacking situation, and it's, and you're absolutely right. We have to find a way to engage the children so they have something better to do. So there's an opportunity. There's an opportunity for better education. There's an opportunity for an economy that supports an opportunity to get a job. And if they're too young to work, that there's places like COA that gets involved in the communities that engage the children so they don't want to go out and steal a car. They're not stealing cars for transportation. They're stealing cars for that charge, that excitement. So let's take care of our kids. Let's make sure they're properly educated. Let's make sure that our economy supports an opportunity for them to get something better in their lives because they deserve it.
Pastor Mike Bennett, next in line, you don't have to answer if you don't want to.
I don't have a problem with answering. But for that question, speaking as a legal Martin once again, when I sit down and I actually interview these young African-American males, for the most part, which has been almost 100% of these motor vehicle thefts, the last question that I ask to them, is there anything that I can do to curb your behavior and your thought process behind wanting to steal these vehicles? And what's your motivation for it? The answer I get is, people are gonna do what they do. Or, we need to get from point A to point B. My rebuttal will be, well, you're only 15. The bus just ain't hitting it no more. We need to get from point A to point B. That may be some reason, or it may be the charge. I don't know. But something has to be done. I think more mentoring programs, me as a League of Martin, we'll be doing a little bit more. We'll be over in the 53206, maybe starting a basketball team as well. We've been doing events like kickball with cops. We did that last September 3rd, and we're gonna be doing a ton more with the community. We'll be over in Sherman Park and picking up individuals that we can actually mentor ourselves to help coach them into these roles.
Thank you.
Short term and long term. You know, carjacking is an effect of a larger cause that I referred to earlier. If a family structure is destroyed, then the children, they run and they raise themselves. My sons are not out carjacking.
Mine either.
And if they was, they would.
I would be them.
Because there's a family structure there. So that's not something that they would find themselves doing. And so in the long term, we need public policy that's family friendly, that restores the family, understanding that it is public policy that destroys. Short term, some of the other things that I agree, you know, Brother Earl Ingram has a football league where every Saturday he had 800 youth that play football all day. Well, that can be replicated all over the city. Baseball is like a dying sport in the city, in the hood. But there needs to be investment in sports, not just basketball, but baseball and other things. There needs to be investment in mentoring programs, running railways. That organization is doing all kinds of wonderful things for young people. But they need to be replicated all over the city. So there has to be investment in the youth. Not law enforcement, not punitive. Especially since that situation was created again by social engineering. I have to keep saying that. Because we didn't do this to ourselves, and the young people didn't do this to themselves. They are victims as well as criminals in terms of, I don't even like to call them criminals, because that's not really what they are by nature. They may be committing crimes, but that's not what they really are.
Thank you, Mr. Muhammad.
So we have no pursuit policy in Milwaukee. Our mayor has gone on record saying that the first time a youth steals a car, it's a joyride. The second time they steal a car, it's a joyride. And the third time, there should be consequences. I disagree. The first time my daughter slaps her sister, I don't say, "Oh, that's okay. I'll wait till the third time you do it." As a parent, try to bring correction swiftly, and I try to do it with consistency. Now, we can have a debate or a talk in the community about what that correction should be. What that correction should be is not my point, and I will say that correction is not Lincoln Hills. But,
amen.
Correction with consistency. We need to show the youth that they can't just do willy-nilly whatever they feel like it because people are going to do what people are going to do, and that they can get away with it with no repercussions. There has to be repercussions, whether that's from the parents, from the grandparents, from the community, from the teacher, from the police officer. We have to have repercussions. And with those repercussions, we have to have redirection. Is it about activities or football? Perhaps. But I don't think that we need to just keep our youth occupied. Our youth have to be educated. They have to be learning. And the reason they need to be educated and learning is because they need to be motivated. You don't get motivated if you don't have a meaning and a purpose. If you're waking up every morning saying, "Well, another day, what am I going to do?" Yeah, carjacking might be in your future. But if you're waking up in the morning saying, "Okay, I got to do this, or I'm going to go see this person, or I'm going to work this job, or I'm going to be with this teacher, or I'm going to play this football," then you have some meaning and some purpose in your life. Does that come from the Department of Corrections? Probably not. But is that possibly necessary? Yes. Does it come from the family? Yes. Does it come from the community? Yes. Does it come perhaps from the synagogue or the church they attend? Yes. So it comes from the community. As we establish meaning and purpose in the lives of our youth and couple that with immediate, swift, expected correction and redirection, that's how we get rid of the problem of having youth carjacking in Milwaukee.
Excuse me, if I may say one other thing. There was an article. There was an article in October 2015 from the Journal of American Medical Association. And it said something profound. It said, gardening and exercise reduces violence.
That is right.
It said, gardening and exercise reduces violence. Sports, Hal, Earl, Ingram stuff, the stuff we just talked about, I would argue that's exercise. The hugs that I spoke about and doing agriculture, that's gardening. I would just say, we tried policing and the Department of Corrections and Lincoln Hills. And I would argue, it ain't working very well. Maybe, just maybe, we should try something different.
Yes,
right.
Yes.
Very brief. The black community, we have to be more assertive and more self-sufficient. We cannot be looking for those outside of our community to do for us what we can't do for ourselves. So we have to take control of our children. We have to create activity for them. We have to build an economic base in our community so that we can, so that that economic reason for carjacking is taken away. We can't wait for some benevolent white person to do for us what we need to do for ourselves.
Thank you, Mr. Marlin.
Subscribe, bitch.